Hey, what's up everyone? Josh Quinones here, and today I'm going to be sharing with you all what is on my Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus. Now, I've had a lot of questions asking what my settings are like, how I have certain things set up and customized, and what kind of case I'm using and so on. So today I'm going to share all of that with you, and hopefully this video will help someone out that wants to try and customize their phone to best fit them as well. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and start with the outside of the device before we get to the inside of it. So I currently have no screen protector on. I usually like rocking without a screen protector because it just makes the screen look a lot more clear, a lot nicer. So that's usually how I have it. And then around back, as you can see, I got this Rinky Fusion case. And the reason I love it so much is because it's still got the clear back. So I'm still able to show off that beautiful white color of the phone, but it's got this nice blue outlining around the edges and then around the camera as well. And then it also just goes great with the wallpaper I have. So you can see it's the blue wallpaper that blends in perfect with the blue edges of this case. And the wallpaper I have is this Wally wallpaper, as you can see, which I'm sure some of you have seen from my last video. And this case as well, a lot of you have seen it in previous videos. And if I'm not using this case, I'm using this one over here, the Rinky Fusion X. Now, if you find yourself interested in any of these, I will make sure to throw a link down below, as well as a link for this wallpaper right here. So I do keep an always on display on. As you can see, I got the time, the date, the battery percentage, and then notifications. And also down here, the fingerprint sensor will pop in and out. You'll be able to see it and then it'll go away. But let's go ahead and go into the device. So here I have my main home screen. This is the main one that I go to once I open up my phone. As you can see, my top widget up here is basically the one that comes with the device, showing me the location, an updated date, the weather, and then we have the Google search bar, which I actually have shrunken down. So let me move it down here. You can actually stretch it out or shorten it up. So I like to keep it short like that and just keep it up here at the top right. And it also kind of goes good with the pill-shaped camera cutout, got the pill-shaped Google search bar. So in my opinion, I just like the way it looks better. And then it's nice and open right here in the middle. And then as far as apps go on my main screen, I got my SmartThings app, which I use to connect with my TV mostly. I don't really have any other Samsung devices except for my phone and then my TV. I do have a gaming monitor, which I have not hooked up yet. Still got to do an unboxing for that, so you guys stay tuned for that. But yes, I usually use this to control my TV. If you see here, I can click on this and it'll take me to a remote that I can use. So that's basically what I use this SmartThings app for. And then if later on I get more Samsung devices, I can use this to control those as well. And then over here on the right, I got the Galaxy Wearable app that I use to be able to customize my sound settings for my Galaxy Buds and also for my smart Galaxy Watch. And then I have folders down here. I got my movie apps, which is Netflix, Hulu, Vudu, Fandango Now. And then my next folder, I have my social media, which is Twitter and Snapchat. So for all of you asking if I have an Instagram, sorry to break it to you, I do not have an Instagram, just Snapchat and Twitter, which I always have linked down in the description below in case anybody wants to follow me. And then my next folder is my YouTube apps, where I have actual YouTube. I got my YouTube Studio, which is what I use to be able to try and keep up with all the comments and try to comment back to each and every one of you. Got my subscriber account, my Social Blade, and then TuneBank is what I use to be able to download videos off of YouTube, or my no copyright music that I use for my videos. So going to the next folder is my actual editing apps that I use to edit my videos that you all see on this channel. PowerDirector is the editing app that I use, and I actually have a video showing how to use this app straight from the phone and then upload it straight to YouTube from the phone. So I will link that video down in the description below in case you want to know how to edit videos on your smartphone for YouTube. And then these two apps over here, PixelLab and PixArt, these are actually the apps that I use to make my thumbnails for the videos on this channel as well. So let's go out of that. And then right here, we got my gallery. And then on the bottom, we have the phone dialer, my email, my Google Chrome, messages, and my camera. Now, my camera settings, let me show you right here. If I go into settings for the rear video facing camera, right now I have it at full HD 60 frames per second. I usually switch it between that and 4K shooting as well. You can shoot up to 60 frames per second in 4K and then regular 4K. Now the UHD without 60 frames, that actually has optical image stabilization. The 60 frame per second one does not. I'll usually use this one if I'm using my gimbal. And then for the front facing camera, I keep that on 4K because the quality of the front-facing camera, now that we can record in 4K, is just amazing, and I'm loving it so far. So let's go out of the camera settings. For now, let's go over to the next page. And up here, you can see I got this big widget of a bunch of little weather symbols right there. We got a cloud with rain. So yes, this is basically giving me the next 4 days of weather, what the weather is going to be like. And then this is for right now in real time. And if I click on it, it goes to the actual app that gives me a couple more days of what the weather is going to be like. I can update it up here. That was 21 minutes ago. If I press update, it'll give me what it is now. But this is actually called the Beautiful Widgets. That's what it's called, Beautiful Widgets. And I have been using this for years. You're able to customize it however you want, whatever kind of weather symbols you want. There's so much that you can actually do with this app. It's pretty crazy. But yes, I've been using this for a very long time, and I continue to use it because I just like the way it looks personally. Now, for the apps on this page, I got my Marriott app for if I'm traveling and I want to look for a hotel, see what the rates are. I got my Google Play Music, the Play Store, Amazon Shopping, got my folder for financing, Venmo, PayPal, my banking, Google Maps, and then my rideshare apps, got my Uber, Lyft, Postmates. I know you see Uber driver there. It's because I did used to drive for Uber, but I haven't driven for it in a long time. I don't even know why I still have that app on this phone, to be honest with you. And then the next folder, I just named it Sell Stuff. I don't know what else to call it, but I got my Offer Up and Let Go on there for when I feel like selling things in my area. And then I got my gaming folder, which got Fortnite, Asphalt 9, Dragon Ball Legends, PUBG Mobile, and then the PlayStation app, which I really like because it actually gives me notifications of when certain friends are playing or certain friends have invited me to play with them as well. So this PlayStation app is pretty cool as well. And it lets me know what's going on with other games as well. And then next to that is Other Stuff is what I named it, because I don't even know what to name this folder either. But yes, it's other stuff like the clock for when I want to set alarms or use a timer. Got my Samsung Notes for typing out my voiceovers for some of the videos on this channel. Got my calculator, Booksy, and Geico Mobile. And for those of you who are wondering what Booksy is, it's actually an app that lets you set appointments for things like haircuts, or if you want to go to a salon, get a massage. There's a bunch of stuff like that. There's so much on here, but I usually use this to schedule an appointment with my brother. Shout out to him for every time I get a haircut. So I will go ahead and schedule with him through this app. So that's it for that page. Let's go to the next and the last page. It's basically just my calendar widget that I keep on this whole screen right here. That way I can just go over, see what the date is if I have to, or see if I have anything going on that day, or what's going to happen next weekend if I have anything planned, when payday is, as you can see there for my regular job. So yeah, this is all I got. You guys, just three pages. Calendar widget. Got my beautiful widgets up here with a couple of these apps and folders, and then my main page. Now, I want to show you guys some of my settings as far as the display goes. A lot of you have been asking me, how do I keep my display? So let me go over here. As you can see, I do have the night mode on. So you can see there, night mode is on. I just like using it better. It's easier on the eyes, especially at night. But I do have the screen mode on vivid because the colors just pop a lot more when watching videos or taking pictures and looking at them. You do got a choice to choose natural as well, but I always like to keep it on vivid. And then the brightness, I also got that on adaptive brightness. I let it go up and down on its own depending on how bright it is. And then my screen resolution, I always keep that on the highest, WQHD+. That way I can get the best out of my screen and take advantage of the beautiful screen on this device. Now, as far as screen timeout goes, I do have it after 10 minutes of inactivity, only because I've been shooting a lot of videos with this lately. So I like to make sure the screen's going to stay on so I don't have to keep waking it during the video. So that is it for that. Also, Video Enhancer, I got that on as well. Makes videos look a lot better when watching videos on your video player. Like I said, I got Vudu, YouTube, Netflix, Hulu. So that works out great. So yeah, that is what's on my device for everybody that's been asking. I hope this video helped out, answered a lot of your questions. I like to keep it simple. Like I said, three pages, got my folders that I need on my main page, other folders over here that if I need them, they're there. But yeah, I like to keep it simple. It's a lot easier for me to use. I am using Samsung's own stock launcher. I usually use a launcher called Launcher Launcher, but I wanted to try sticking with this one for as long as I can to see if I can get used to it and be able to use the S10 Plus the way it was meant to be used. But later on, if I find myself not really liking this, then I will switch to a different launcher. And as you can see, I did actually change the icons though. That is one thing that I did change. just by going, holding and pressing the screen, going into themes, pressing icons. And this one is actually called Walk on Mars. I just think it has a lot of a cleaner look to it. It's a lot more simple. And I also am using a couple of the features from the GoodLock 2019, like the taskbar, the task manager right here. So you can see there, it's looking a lot different. And there's just so much you can do on the app. GoodLock 2019, you can change the lock screen style. You can customize your quick panel. There's just so much you can do to customize your device. If you guys would like me to do a full walkthrough video with this app, so you can find out just how much you can customize your any Samsung Galaxy device using this app, let me know down in the comment sections below and I will take that into consideration. But yes, so this has been what is on my Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus. I hope you guys liked it and I hope it was able to help anybody out. Like I said, if you see anything you like on here, like the cases or the wallpaper, I will make sure to throw a link down in the description below in case you find yourself interested. But that has been it for now. Let me know your thoughts down in the comment sections below. Don't forget to leave a huge thumbs up on this video if you did like it. And don't forget to hit that subscribe button and hit that bell so you don't miss out on any other future videos to come. But for now, thank you all so much for watching. This is Josh Quinones. I will see you on the next one. Peace out.